Good evening, everybody. Welcome to our service this evening. Now, first things first, we had a bit of a problem with the microphone last week. And this week I happen to be on my own because Paul's not home from work yet. So tonight's service is going to be a service of spiritual communion rather than actual communion. It doesn't make so much difference to you at home, but it just means that I'm not going to be doing the Eucharistic prayer in the service. We'll just have a time of prayer where we connect with God. So we're celebrating St. Clare tonight. So I've got this service on my phone at the same time. Could you just put a little comment or a thumbs up or something just to let me know that you can hear me all right, whoever it is that's watching at the moment? That would really help me out because we had a bit of a problem last week, didn't we, with the sound. So I'm just hoping that you can all hear me okay. So before I get into it completely, if you could just let me know, that would be really helpful. And I'm just going to check now in the Facebook group. So I can see at the moment there's three of you watching, so that's good. So if you wouldn't mind just saying sounds okay or something like that in the comments, and I'll just wait for you to do that while I give you some notices. So please, will you say something if you can hear, so I know to carry on? Okay, that would be great. Oh, somebody's commented. Hi Hazel, can you hear me all right, Hazel? That would be great. So just let me know if you can hear me. This week, our service in church on Sunday will be at Clown. So we're in Clown Church this coming Sunday at 10 o'clock for the service. We will live stream the service at 10 o'clock on Facebook, on the St. John the Baptist Facebook page. But you might want to wait if you're not actually going to come and attend in person. You might like to wait until the evening, because by the evening I then download the video and I edit it a little bit and put all the words up on the screen so you can join in at home. So you might prefer to do that. And the good thing about that as well is that I flip the screen so that it's the right way round, so it's a bit easier to watch. Because when I live stream, I use the selfie mode on my camera so that I can see myself to make sure that I'm always in shot. And that's why everything appears the wrong way round. I know some people have been getting confused about that. So, excellent. Everyone says it sounds okay, so that's good. We're in the right place. Perfect. So I just managed to waffle a little bit to make sure everyone could hear me. So today's the festival of St. Clare of Assisi. She was one of the companions of Francis of Assisi, and she founded the order of that's known as the Poor Clares after her, which are the nuns in the Franciscan movement around the world. So we're celebrating St. Clare today. Her name means enlightened one. It must be a similar root to the word clarity. There's a bit of a theme of light running through the readings that we've got for today's service. So hopefully, if everything's okay, I will move on to my presentation so that you can see me. And right, I'm just turning the sound down on my phone. All very complicated. Hopefully you can see everything okay. So we're ready to start our service. Oh no, we're not. Yes we are. There we are. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you and also with you. And so we prepare ourselves to meet with God by saying, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And so we come to confess our sins together, acknowledging where we've messed up this week. We have not always worshipped God, our Creator. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. We have not always followed Christ, our Saviour. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. We have not always trusted in the Spirit, our guide. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So the prayer for today for Saint Clare. God of peace, who in the poverty of the Blessed Clare gave us a clear light to shine in the darkness of this world, give us grace so to follow in her footsteps, that we may at the last rejoice with her in your eternal glory. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and for ever. Amen. Beautiful reading from the Song of Songs. Set me as a seal upon your heart, as a seal upon your arm, for love is strong as death, passion fierce as the grave. Its flashes are flashes of fire, a raging flame. Many waters cannot quench love, neither can floods drown it. If one offered for love all the wealth of one's house, it would be utterly scorned. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. A reading from the second letter of Paul to the Corinthians. It is the God who said, "Let light shine out of darkness," who has shone in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. But we have this treasure in clay jars, so that it may be made clear that this extraordinary power belongs to God and does not come from us. We are afflicted in every way, but not crushed, perplexed, but not driven to despair, persecuted, but not forsaken, struck down, but not destroyed, always carrying in the body the death of Jesus, so that the life of Jesus also may be made visible in our bodies. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. So hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Saint John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, "Abide in me as I abide in you. Just as the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Those who abide in me and I in them bear much fruit, because apart from me you can do nothing. Whoever does not abide in me is thrown away like a branch and withers. Such branches are gathered, thrown into the fire and burned. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, ask for whatever you wish and it will be done for you. My Father is glorified by this, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. So may I speak in the name of the living God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Born in 1193 in Assisi of a wealthy family, Clare caught the joy of a new vision of the gospel from Francis's preaching. She escaped from home. It doesn't say how. There's probably a very interesting story behind that. She escaped from home first to the Benedictines, and then to a Beguine style group, which is kind of a sort of, I guess it was the equivalent of a commune in those days. And she chose a contemplative way of life when she founded her own community, which lived in corporate poverty, understood as dependence on God, with a fresh democratic lifestyle. Clare became the first woman to write a religious rule for women. And it showed in it, and in it showed great liberty of spirit in dealing with earlier prescriptions. During the long years after Francis's death, she supported his earlier companions in their desire to remain faithful to his vision, as she did. So Clare is a really important figure for all Franciscans, and the Franciscans have had a tremendous impact on the church throughout the world and continue to do so. And I count many friends as Franciscans. And Clare is very special. She's often in the shadow of St. Francis, and yet she was just as important as him, really, in many ways, and was very important, of course, in encouraging women in the ministry. And the order that she founded is known as the Poor Clares after her. I was looking up some of the things that she said, and I found a couple of quotes I'd like to share with you this evening. She said this: "We become what we love, and who we love shapes what we become. If we love things, we become a thing. If we love nothing, we become nothing. Imitation is not a literal mimicking of Christ. Rather, it means becoming the image of the beloved, an image disclosed through transformation. This means we are to become vessels of God's compassionate love for others. We are to become vessels of God's compassionate love for others." So what she's saying there is that we become what we love. And so if we love God, we will become like him. And the only way we can do that is to dwell in Christ, as that reading from John's Gospel we heard, "Abide in me," Jesus says. We have to be connected to the vine. Otherwise we can't bear fruit and we can't show the love of God in the world. Something else that she said shortly before she died herself was this: "Go forth in peace, for you have followed the good road. Go forth without fear, for he who created you has made you holy, has always protected you and loves you as a mother. Blessed be you, my God, for having created me." Blessed be you, my God, for having created me. So we give thanks today for Clare's ministry and for all the movement of the Franciscans around the world, and especially today we think and pray for the Poor Clare communities around the world, working with some of our poorest communities, sharing that love of Christ, becoming vessels of God's compassionate love for others. Might we do the same. And remember what Clare said: we become what we love. So let us love God with our whole hearts. So in peace, let us pray to Jesus our Lord, whoever lives to make intercession for us. Saviour of the world, be present in all places of suffering, violence and pain, and bring hope even in the darkest night. We pray for the people of Lebanon and especially the city of Beirut. We pray for the people of Belarus and for peace there. We pray for those continuing to struggle for justice in Hong Kong. We pray for all governments grappling with the pandemic, and pray for New Zealand as it returns to a lockdown today. We pray for our own nation. We pray for all children waiting for their exam results on Thursday. Inspire us, O Lord, to continue your work of reconciliation today, inspired by the example of St. Clare. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord of the Church, empower by your Spirit all Christian people. Especially today we give thanks for the Franciscans who work around the world and for the Poor Clares. We pray for the work of your Church in every land. Give us grace to proclaim the gospel joyfully in word and deed. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Shepherd and guardian of our souls, guide and enable all who lead and serve our community, on those on whom we depend for our daily needs. Grant that we may seek the peace and welfare of this place. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Great physician, stretch out your hand to bring comfort, wholeness and peace to all who suffer, in body, mind or spirit. You might like to name out loud people who are on your heart at the moment, who are in need of God's healing touch. I pray today for my friend Bex and my friend Simon, both who are suffering with cancer. Fill us with compassion, that we may be channels of your healing love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Conqueror of death, remember for good those whom we love but see no longer. We remember especially today our dear priest, the Reverend David Hull, who died last week. Help us to live this day in the sure and certain hope of your eternal victory. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. So let us commend ourselves and all for whom we pray to the mercy and protection of God. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. So now we come to share virtual peace with one another, remembering that Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross, and we meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you, and also with you. So we offer one another a virtual sign of peace in whichever way we feel comfortable. Peace be with you all. And so in simplicity today, we are having a service of spiritual communion because I'm taking this service on my own at home today. Paul's still at work. And so we join together in the words that Jesus taught to his friends. Let us really let these words sink in as we pray them together this evening. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. And so we come to our act of spiritual communion. You might like to change your posture. You may like to kneel or hold your hands out, just to spend a few moments with your God. In union, dear Father, with Christian people throughout the world and across the centuries gathered to make Eucharist, hearing your holy word and receiving the precious body and blood, I offer you praise and thanksgiving. Even though I am exiled from tasting the bread of heaven and drinking the cup of life, I pray that you will unite me with all the baptized and with your Son who gave his life for us. Come, Lord Jesus, dwell in me, and send your Holy Spirit, that I may be filled with your presence. wish to pray this out loud. Thanks be to you, Lord Jesus Christ, for all the benefits you have given me, for all the pains and insults you have borne for me. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart. O most merciful Redeemer, friend and brother, may I know you more clearly, love you more dearly, and follow you more nearly, day by day. Amen. Lord, in these days of mercy, make us quiet and prayerful. In these days of challenge, make us stronger in you. In these days of emptiness, take possession of us. In these days of waiting, open our hearts to the mystery of your cross. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let's bow our heads to receive God's blessing. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you this day and always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. Thank you for joining me this evening. Our next service will be on Thursday morning over the telephone. If you haven't been to phone church yet, it's quite an experience. You're very welcome to join us. All you need is a phone. You can ring us on the mobile or the landline, and you can find all the information on our church website, bcjj.org.uk. Hopefully I'll see some of you soon, and we'll see you at Clown Church at 10 o'clock this Sunday. Take care, everyone. Cheerio.